Agora, falha, tisses feira, funfeira, coins, tutei, conatal, capau, silva, espada, price, forças, fiscos, silva, price, what's the difference between those two? Tissarek was from Sin Alpha, role by Peter Crawford, on April 22, 2021. The spot price on April 22, 2021, at the time they released this article, the silver spot price was $26, but the physical silver price was $37. Premium at triple normal levels are still a near out of stock. Investment and industrial demands have been soaring and have been expected remaining elevator again in 2021. As we progress into a post health issue recovery inflation risk and stimulus checks pending, there is more to come. I like to push the silver much higher and higher. The spot price was trading in $26, but you cannot buy at a price. You have to pay at least 50% more to get a physical silver. That's right. If you want a silver right now, you will need to pay at least $35 per ounce if you want to choose a generic silver from a private refinery. But if you're looking to get a government issue coins, you have sometimes you have to wait at least 1 month to be delivery, and the price is at least $37 per ounce. So it's $11 over at the current silver price. In the past year, premiums on physical silver have tripled from normal levels. Bullion tiers have been overrun. Price storage are now commonplace, with Cosmo waiting 3 weeks or longer for shipment. The silver market has rarely, if ever, experienced anything like this. Demand have not only soared, it has maintained its level since last year. So what happening? Well, a lot of things happening. From social media attention and the failing mining supply to a safe haven and industrial demands, the silver market is on fire. And the most sign indicates this trend is only going to be intensify. In late January, Wall Street Bets, the top USP, supposed trigger a call to action to buy silver when they call silver short. Bullion tiers are immediately shocked by a tsunami of buying. To be fair, that happened before, but this time has been different, as the buy waves has yet to let up. Silver prices spike from $25 to $21 before subsiding, but the demands for physical silver haven't, and is seen is unlikely to diminish for some time yet. Throughout this have been a massive buy waves. Silver demands actually first jumped back in March 2020 as the initial health issue, stocks caused much of the world's economies to shut down. Since then, silver been hot, and by our accounts, that seems like to be continuing. Silver gains are impressive of 47% in 2020, and has been trading sideways for the past 9 months. But based on fundamentals and technicals, the metal appears set to be strong again and again this year. The Silver Institute recent forecast global silver demands will rise 11% in 2021 to reach 1.025 billion ounces. They argue that improved microeconomics are supportive of silver mines demand drives. Based on sustained robust buying over the past year, It's not surprised the institute expecting fiscal demands will reach a 6-year high of 257 million ounces global silver ETP, which is short by exchange traded products. Holdings were up outstanding 321 million ounces in 2020 alone to reach 1.04 billion ounces. The more than an entire year supply of silver from mining, recycling, and hedging. Then, from January 1st to February 4th this year alone, ETP holdings saw another 137.6 million ounces to a new record high, 1.18 billion ounces. Let's see just running here. As you can see from the following table, net fiscal investment was up 16% last year. After already came 12% in 2019. At the same time, mining supply has fallen starting since 2015, dropping 5% in the last current year. So the demand is high and the supply is less because the mining supply, where the silver comes from, is dropping 5%, while the demand was 16% last year. So there's a negative 11% negative on silver after a period if you compare with whatever they extract from the crown and whatever is the demand is. A recent analysis report from Harris Precious Metals say the foresee silver prices outperform gold again this year, supporting on by raising inflation and the bonus industrial demand as the economy recovers from the health issue. The analysis say consumption from industrial ends using the forecasting to extend 4 years high of 510 million ounces this year, with strong growth of the electrical and electronics and the photovoltaic PV section. They went on to say last time the 5 year break inflation rate was the high was in 2011. That's when it happened the real estate crisis. And silver was trading around $48 an ounce, almost up the core in price, with precious metals seen as efficient hedge against inflation. Silver inflation expecting should provide upside for the silver. The Silver Institute also sees demand to be sizable, reaching a 4 year high of 510 million ounces, up to 90% over 2020. They expect electrical and electronics demands to drive the increase, as 5G technology help push the sector's consumption of 300 million ounces. The Institute sees a gains from the PV sector reaching 105 million ounces, or about 10% of total demand. Solar panel manufacturers have graduated listening to per unit silver consumption, but has been practical limit. According to SP crop path analysis, crop installation of solar panel are forecast to grow 7% or of 8% a year into 2025, seeing support of common bodies developing corporate. So basically from now on, starting on 2020 until 2025, you're gonna see huge need for silver when included the electrical cars, solar panel, clean energy, and others will be like a huge demanding for industrial physical silver, and still have to have enough silver for the retail market. So silver, there's no way to go down at this point, okay? Because the forecast is upwards. They never needed that much silver. You see how slow come from 2015 until 2019 growth slowly. After that, start to jump in high and high. That's only talk about industrial, okay? The Institute forecasts silver requirements from the automotive sector to be especially vigorous, with demands of 50 million silver ounces in 2020, it's expected to jump 80% to almost 90 million ounces by 2025. If these electrical vehicles use 25 to 50 grams per vehicle, so they use the average almost 2 ounces of silver for each car, near double the silver requirement of internal combustion engineer technology. The Lightweight Consulting sees EV cells accounted for near 1/3 of all new vehicle sales by 2030. 1/3 is 33%, it's a lot. In addition, printed circuit boards electronics make up the largest single demand sector. A 20% of total demands from 60% of industrial. There is a current or shortage of semiconductors exacerbated by pandemic as demand has shifted towards TVs, home computer, and gaming consoles. In fact, this pent-up demand can be seen as an opportunity as industry strives to meet with the silver supply. The acceleration has begun. In previous precious metals bull market, silver has typically outpaced gold gain. I don't expect this time will be different. And given the outsized gain silver produced last year, double gold return, we will be on our way towards the outcome. The silver ratio might be most than indicator point to this scenario. That's the silver and the gold ratio from the past 5 years. From the ratio fell rapidly and dramatic as it was cut almost in half with just 12 months. Throughout, both gold and silver price have rising since the ratio's peak at 125. Silver gains have clear outpaced gold near a 2-to-1 basis. Bank of America commodity analysts say in a recent report that they see silver averaging near $30 this year. The seed was expected 281 million ounce supply shortage and 90% highest industrial demand. A Goldman Sachs recent repeat his bullish view on silver, say the project the metal prices to reach $33 per ounce is pulled by President Biden's drive towards increased renewable energy. All these indicators sky high premiums on silver coins and pores, demand forecast to keep rising. And a rapidly falling gold silver ratio paint a very bullish picture for silver. And that's why I believe the silver bull market has entered the acceleration phase. Wise investors definitely won't wait to be left behind. Now's the ideal time to start buying silver equities. I think that this article was well put. And was wrote by Peter Kraft on April 24 to see Alpha website. If you guys want more information, read more about that, feel free to go to the website. And was really nice analysis from the silver. And that's exactly what we're expecting. The ratio is going down between silver and the gold, and the main thing for silver, especially from now until 2025, will be extremely high. The government expecting 2030, the California signed a law by 2030, all those cars have to be electrical vehicles car, EVs, which means they need a lot of silver. That's the state of California, and that of course will apply state by state throughout the United States. France, by 2040, all those vehicles, all those cars have to be electrical cars. That's already signed for. And the main to start it. Okay, everything, and not even talk about green energy. Okay, because solar panel needs a lot of silver. And if they can apply from coal or so different way to extract the energy for household, etc., to clean energy, it's not gonna be enough silver underground to supply all those demand in short time because everything came at the same time. I think it has time to do your cost average. If the silver is high right now, by little to cost average because it's not gonna go down. Okay, tend to go up from now on. It's not a crisis happening with 2011, went to $48 and then jumped back to 14 throughout the years and then never came back again. And this crisis, unfortunately, is way more stronger than 2008 to 2011 because back then was just one sector, was a real estate sector. But now it's a worldwide crisis, and a lot of countries, they not even see the light by the end of the tunnel. So this problem came to stay for a long time, unfortunately, and apply for any sectors, okay? Apply for retail, for clothing, for anything you think of, apply. Okay, so this is way more strong, unfortunately, than whatever happened in 2008. So and then came up the clean energy, electrical vehicles, and etc. I will say the silver is going to be at least $40, $45 by the end of this year as a fiscal silver. Okay, and next week on Saturday, next year on Saturday, basically May 1st, all those huge corporations, refineries, etc., they try to do the silver squeeze, physical silver squeeze. What happened from Wall Street Bets was paper silver. Right now they want to do physical silver squeeze to try to buy as much physical silver to deliver them from COMEX, LPMA, and then they will make sure they kind of try to clean out the fault from those silver controllers around the world. And from that point, of course, the silver is kind of skyrocketing, okay? Because everything about supply and demand. Okay, guys, that's all I have right now. If you like this video, please make sure to click a like, make a comment, subscribe. Share this video. We will make a video talking about coins, money, and investment, as well precious metals. And I'll see you next time. Thank you.